All right, for this video, we are continuing with our home office deduction for self-employed taxpayers in TurboTax. So in the previous videos, we've covered scenarios where we had a home office deduction for a tenant, right? So if you're renting a property, what kind of expenses can you deduct? What does that look like on the 8829? And we also looked at using the simplified method. So you can take either the simplified method or actual expenses. But now for this video, we want to look at how would we complete the 8829, the home office deduction, using actual expenses and in a scenario where we are the homeowner, so we're not a tenant renting the property. And what you'll notice is there are some significant differences here because we're deducting things like mortgage interest, property taxes, and we can claim depreciation expense on the home, right? That's something that a tenant cannot do. If you're renting a property, you cannot claim depreciation expense on the property. So we're gonna run through the fact pattern here, the numbers, and then we're gonna jump into the tax return and start entering those details. So again, continuing with the similar example we had before, we've got John, taxpayer, runs a consulting business from home. He has an office, dedicated office, which is 150 square feet. It's used regularly, it's used exclusively as the office, so it qualifies. And in this case, John owns his home. So he still has a mortgage on it, but as the homeowner, he can claim depreciation expense. So if we look at some of the numbers here, and all this information will be relevant in order to complete the 8829. So John purchased the house in 2017 for $150,000, and the value of the land accounted for $25,000 of the purchase price. Now that's really important because what we'll find is that land is not a deductible expense. So you cannot depreciate the value of the land, only the building itself. Now the mortgage interest that he paid for the year was $3,050. He paid some property taxes, $1,900. His utilities all in, electric, gas, and internet was $200 for the month or $2,400 for the whole year. His homeowner's insurance premiums, $2,000 for the year. And then he did some repairs on the home. So he painted the entire exterior of the home and the expense was $3,000. Now, again, in this example, we're gonna be using the actual expenses. The simplified method, you could just use the square footage of the office times a fixed rate, which is $5 per square foot for 2022. Or we're gonna go with the actual expenses where we track those actual expenses and then take a percentage of the total. Okay, so let's look at TurboTax and start entering some of this information. So we're in the TurboTax window here, the wages and income section. And you'll notice here, we've already got the self-employed income and expense. So Schedule C has already been entered for everything else, right? So the income and expenses for John, Taxpayer Consulting LLC. So what we need to do now is go back in and edit it and include the home office category. Now, if you go in here to edit it and you don't see the home office section, you can add expenses for work. You can go down here and add an item and then go ahead and update to include the home office deduction. So we're gonna go ahead and start this, and it's gonna ask us a number of yes or no questions, go through the prompts, and then we'll start entering all of the financial information. Okay, so we do have a home office, answer is yes. It's asking us if we had more than one during the year. Now, we only had the one home office during the year, but what they're getting at here is if we had multiple homes or rental properties that we were going back and forth, then we might need to enter information for more than one office, right? So for example, let's say you started off the year in one property and then you sold it and moved into another. Well, you would have to enter information for both because obviously the layout is gonna change, the expenses, right? Your home office might be 150 square feet in the first property, but then it jumps to 200 in the second one, right? So you've got different numbers, different values, and so you have to enter the information separately for each property. Any of these unique situations apply to our home office for 2022. We did not share it with another person, and we did not use this home office for our consulting business and other businesses or lines of work, Right, because if you use it for multiple businesses, you should arguably be separating the expenses or allocating it across the multiple businesses. In our case, that doesn't apply. Right, so we're going to go ahead and hit none apply and continue on through. Name of the home office, we're just going to use the street address for the property. Obviously, this is not a real address, 123 street address, but that's what we've named John's house. About the home office for our consulting business, was this used for work only and nothing else? Yes, right? So remember, when you have a home office, in order for it to qualify, it has to be used exclusively for that purpose. It can't double as a guest room or a game room or something like that. It's got to be just used for the office. We did regularly use this home office for the consulting business, and it was the primary place where we worked, right? So we didn't do any other work for the consulting business outside of this home office. We did everything from that location. All right, we're going to continue on through. Based on this info, we qualify for the deduction. That's great. Now we're going to enter, when did we start using it for work? In our examples, we've been consistently using the start of the year. So Jan 1, 2022, we started using it. Obviously, if you started using it at a different time, enter that time, and what will happen is there will be a proration of the expenses. Obviously, you can't deduct expenses when it was not being used as a home office. So how many months did we use it? At least 15 days during each month. We use it year round, right? So greater than 15 days each month we had for home office use. And then what percentage of our work from consulting was done from this location? So again, 100%, right? We don't have another office location where we do work. We don't go out to meet to clients or customers. We do everything remotely from our home office, and so that's it. So that's why we have 100%. All right, square footage information, right? So this is very, very important because this is what drives the ratio of how many or what percentage of the expenses you can claim. So the home office size is 150 square feet. John's house was 2,200 square feet in total, right? So 150 divided by 2,200, that percentage is going to be what we can claim when we input all these actual expenses. So the first prompt it gives us, like the other videos, is to just claim the simplified method for the deduction. So simplified method is just the square footage times that fixed rate. So it'll give us $750. We can go that option if you'd like. The nice thing about that is, as it says here, you know, if we use simplified method, you don't have to have receipts or records of the expenses. If you have actual expenses, you do need the receipts and records, which we have. So we're going to go ahead and claim the actual expenses. So we're going to say no to simplified method. We want to claim actual expenses, okay? Now, how do you want to enter the information? So you can do either one, right? So quick entry, you just enter it directly by line item onto the 8829 effectively, right? Which is the home office deduction form. But we're going to go with the guide me. So it gives us some Q&A and helps direct us a little bit and provides us a little more color and background on kind of the home office deduction. So previous videos, we looked at rental use, right? So I rented the home that I'm using, but in this case, no, we're saying we own the home. And this is very important because, again, if you say you rent a home, you're not going to be able to claim depreciation expense, right? Obviously, you don't claim mortgage interest deductions because you're not paying the mortgage. You're just paying a rental rate to the landlord. But in this case, we own the home, and so that is going to determine what kind of expenses are available to us. Now, the mortgage interest. So what John has not done yet is entered any information from 1098s about the mortgage interest he paid, right? And that's because he's just claiming the standard deduction. But now the mortgage interest is relevant, right? So we're going to enter the information on the mortgage expense. So let's say bank, you know, Bank Name Inc. is the lender. So you should have the 1098 in front of you, right? Which shows the total amount of mortgage interest, mortgage insurance premiums, points, real estate taxes, all that kind of stuff. So I do not co-own this loan with someone else. It's not a seller finance loan, right? So we did get a 1098, so none of these apply. Okay, so the mortgage interest that John paid, if we go back to our fact pattern really quickly here, So the total mortgage interest on the 1098 was $3,050. Okay, so the mortgage interest paid $3,050. We don't have any information in boxes 2, 3, or 7. Did you take out this loan in 2022? No. Remember, John purchased it back in 2017. Did we pay any points when we took out the loan? No. He didn't pay any points. So it says, I paid points when I financed, purchased, or opened a home equity line, or I've already deducted all the points, or I didn't pay. So he didn't pay any points. Is the loan secured by the property? Yes, right? So this is a purchase money loan, right? So the loan amount is secured by the actual real property itself. Okay. So we've got the lender in there, the interest, $3,050. Include this interest in the home office deduction. All right, perfect. Now the reason why they're asking us this is because it's certainly possible to have multiple properties that you might use for a personal residence and maybe a vacation home. But the vacation home, the mortgage you're paying, you never use it for a home office, right? And so that's why, you know, if you have vacation home mortgage interest, but you don't have a home office there, then you would uncheck this, right? Because you're not allocating interest expense to the home office if it doesn't exist. All right, so now we're going to get into the home office expenses. So it says, based on the square footage entered, our home office percentage is 6.82%, right? So that's the 150 square feet divided by the 2,200 total. Continue on through expenses. So asking us here, do we have expenses that apply just to the office or to the entire home? In our case, we don't have any direct home office expenses. Everything applies to the entire home. So what would be an example? You know, if you had, let's say you had, you know, interior work or painting done just to the home office, then arguably that applies just to the home office and not the entire property. Also, if you had like a special, you know, internet line or something installed that was only being used in that home office, it couldn't be used throughout the rest of the house, then arguably, okay, maybe this just applies to the home office. But in our case, what we'll see is all the expenses that we've incurred are indirect. So they apply to the whole property, and then we're just allocating a piece to the home office based on the size of the home office. All right, so we didn't have any mortgage insurance premiums. All right, so we can leave that as zero. Any excess mortgage interest? So no, right, so excess mortgage interest occurs if we have a mortgage and we're not itemizing deductions. If we have a mortgage that is more than $1 million or $750,000, depending on the loan origin date, or if we have a home equity loan and all of our mortgages exceed the value of the home at the time the loan is closed. Now, in John's case here, he actually does have an issue here, right? Because he is not going to be claiming itemized tax deductions on Schedule A. He's claiming the standard. So if you have a mortgage and you're not itemizing deductions, there's a particular part on the form 8829 that you have to input the information, right? And this differs if you are itemizing deductions, right? So your mortgage interest and your real estate taxes goes in a different area. So in this case, we're going to answer yes, because we do have a mortgage, but we know that we're not going to be itemizing deductions. John is just going to take the standard tax deduction. So we're going to go ahead and click yes. Now it's going to ask us enter the 2022 amount, the entire home, excess mortgage interest. So if we have excess mortgage interest and it's included in the 3050, enter zero. If you have a mortgage but you are not itemizing deductions, enter the mortgage here, right? So this is us. We have a mortgage. We're not itemizing deductions, so we're gonna go ahead and enter just the whole amount. So $3,050. Continue on through. All right, real estate taxes. This is a similar issue with the mortgage interest, right? How you complete this really depends upon whether you were claiming your itemized deductions or not. Okay, so it asks us here, if you paid real estate taxes but are not itemizing, do not enter your real estate taxes here. Enter them as excess real estate taxes later on. Okay, so that's us. So What we're going to do is we're going to just continue on through. So we're going to leave this blank because it is telling us here, don't enter the real estate taxes here if we are not itemizing. We're going to do them on a later screen. All right, any excess real estate taxes. Okay, this is where we enter, right? So if you're not able to deduct all of your real estate taxes, you have excess real estate taxes, yes. So what were the total taxes we paid? Okay, so John paid real estate taxes of $1,900. So I'm gonna go ahead and enter the $1,900. Actually, I don't need the cents there. All right, now the utilities. So if we look at the utilities, John's utilities, 200 per month, 2,400 for the whole year, all right? So I'm gonna enter 2,400 bucks for the whole year, that's fine. Home repairs, right? So fill in the total expenses for the whole home. We will prorate based on a percentage of the home that was used at the home office, right? So what were our home repairs? We paid a painter to paint the exterior for $3,000. So if I go here, $3,000. All right, that's great. Go ahead and click continue. It does prompt us to enter homeowners insurance specifically. That's great. So our homeowners insurance was $2,000 for the whole year. So I'm gonna do $2,000. Any other expenses? So homeowners dues, home security, right? So in our case, we're keeping the example pretty simple, but obviously if you, you can click here and see more examples of the stuff that would apply, right? So it'll jog your memory a bit. But in our case, we're just gonna say, no other expenses. So casualty losses, right? So did we have property that was damaged for these reasons, right? So fire, flood, rain, robbery, and it's going to ask us, okay, if we had damage, to what extent do we have insurance cover it? To the extent insurance didn't reimburse you, you might be able to claim a casualty loss. Okay, so here's our expenses. We got the mortgage interest, the real estate taxes, utilities, that's great, repairs and maintenance, insurance, no other expenses. Okay, perfect. So we're going to go ahead and continue on through. Now is where we get to the depreciation, right? So this is different than the rental. Right, the tenants don't get to depreciate the house. We do because we own it. So we're going to continue on through. So we're depreciating our home. We haven't had any improvements. So we just have the one home. All right, so description of the home, we're going to do, 1, 2, 3, street address. The cost of the whole home, remember, is $150,000. John paid for it. Right, and then the land was $25,000. The date we purchased it, he bought it back in 2017. So let's say he bought it, February 2017. So he's had it a couple of years. Date I started using in the business, right? So we've already entered that we started the business or started using the home office on Jan 1, 2022. So that's auto-populating it there. Right. Okay, so I'm going to continue this on through. Here's the percentage that you use your home for the business, 6.82%. Okay. All right, and so there's our depreciation deduction. So what they've done is they've taken the value of the land, the $125,000, right? Because remember, total price is $150,000. $25,000 is the land, so $125,000 is the building, and that's going to be the depreciation expense for the year. All right, and so it's giving us kind of an initial, our home office deduction is $1,051. That's great. Remember, the simplified method was going to give us $750. So we are getting a little bit more of a deduction because of the actual expenses rather than the simplified method. So what I want to do now is actually go to the 8829 and walk through some of the elements. So if I go down to Tax Tools, the Print Center, we are going to pull up the 1040. All right, preview it and then look at the 8829 specifically. So I'm gonna 2022 federal, just to return, open this up. Let me zoom in a bit for you so it's easier to see. So we've got page one of the return there, right? Not too much has changed there. But what has changed, if we look at the Schedule C initially, so this is John's Schedule C, right? He's got his gross revenues here, the various expenses reported on lines 8 through 27A. And then down here on line 30 is where we have our home office deduction. So the business use of home expense is reported here on line 30, but this number obviously flows from the 8829, so that's what we want to look at next. So if we scroll down to the 8829, okay, here we go. So business use of home. So some of the information that was necessary, at least at the beginning, to compute the percentage, right? So we have the 150 square foot home office, 2200 is the total house, and there's our percentage, 6.82%. All right. Now, if we go down here, you notice here in part two, this is where it's really important, again, with respect to claiming the standard versus the itemized deductions. So if you were claiming the itemized tax deductions, right? So you're filling out a Schedule A to report the mortgage interest, the taxes, medical expenses, things like that, charitable contributions. The mortgage interest and the real estate taxes will be reported up here on lines 10 and 11. Because we are claiming the standard deduction, we have to report those amounts instead down here on lines 16 and 17. So that's why the mortgage interest and the real estate taxes are reported down here. And then we can see the other elements, right? So we have the insurance here, repairs and maintenance are reported here, the utilities. There's our total, 12,350. And then it's asking us here on line 24, multiply this total by the amount on line 7, right? So our percentage. So here's the total indirect expenses multiplied by the home office percentage gives us $842. So that's how much of the household expenses that we're deducting. Then down here on line 30, $209, but the calculation comes from down here, lines 37 through 42, right? So we have the basis in the home, right? So $150,000 purchase price, $25K was the land, so obviously that's not deductible. So what we're doing is the basis of the building is $125,000. The business use percentage, right? So that's the 6.82% of the basis in the building, and there's our depreciation percentage, and we ultimately have $209 of depreciation expense that is deducted. So when we add the 842 and the 209, there is our home office deduction of $1,051. All right. Now, TurboTax will have additional worksheets if you want to print them to see how they calculated this in more detail. But obviously, those forms and schedules aren't required to be sent to the IRS. So that's why we're just looking at the summary page here. But again, this is the beauty of TurboTax and other kind of tax prep software. As long as you've entered everything precisely where it needs to be, the software will generate these numbers for you. So it takes a lot of the guesswork out of it. All right, so I hope that was helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave me a comment below. Look forward to seeing you on the next video. Thanks so much.